Hello everybody and welcome to this demonstration in which I'm going to show you how we can create and work with sketches in Shaper 3D. Before we get started, let's make sure we have the unit system set to centimeter and all our snap options are turned on. To create a sketch, all we need to do is go into a specific view. I will start with top view. You see now the grid along the Y and X axis. Select sketch. I will select rectangle and from the origin, I draw a rectangle. Exit sketch. I will zoom out a little bit and rotate my view. There we are. To now create a sketch that is perpendicular to that rectangle, I will go to front view. The grid is now aligned to the Z and X axis. Create sketch, rectangle, and I will draw my rectangle. Exit and go into 3D view. You noticed when I exited the sketch and rotated my view, the grid was still aligned along the Z and X axis. And the moment I released my finger, it snapped back to the ground plane. To create now a sketch on construction plane, I can select a sketch, then select add plane, move this plane up, select the plane and add sketch. And as you see, the grid was positioned onto that construction plane and the camera was moved into perpendicular position. I will draw my rectangle. Exit the sketch. Now pay attention. I zoom out and now I go into 3D view. And you can see how the grid is still aligned to that construction plane. The moment I release the finger, as I said, it will snap back to the ground plane. I will remove this rectangle and this construction plane and this rectangle. Then I will zoom in, select this sketch, draw a geometry, and then chamfer this corner because we can also add sketches right onto faces of geometry. I will select this face, select sketch, and now you see actually the snapping points, the corners and the center. And from there, I can create a rectangle perfectly centered onto this rectangle. When you stay in sketch mode, you see then you can go into the 3D view and the grid remains this way. This is very handy. The moment I hit exit sketch, the grid resets again. Let's take a look at how easy it is to draw a water bottle. I will go to the front view, zoom in a little bit, move the grid down, hit sketch, and then I draw a line to the left, a line up. I will do this on purpose a little bit crooked, a line to the left, a line down, and on the left side, I will continue and add a line vertical. This is a common practice with a sketch engine that you draw the layout, basic proportions, and now we can add sketch constraints to massage the sketch into the shape we want. And this process is also very easy in Shaper. This point I do not want to move, so I will select and lock it. All these lines should be horizontal or vertical. Double tap to select all, and then add the horizontal vertical constraint. To add dimensions, I simply select a line and enter the value. You see, this is very easy and fast. I will zoom out a little bit. This point I can move up. And now I would like to add an arc and close the sketch. To draw an arc, naturally with the pencil, I simply draw an arc, so from the left point to the right point, with an arc motion. There we are. The arc to the line should always be tangent, so let's add a tangent constraint. I can also, down here, add an arc. We also have the ability to switch directly to the arc command. So there is my arc. Then I add tangent constraints, select the arc. I can slide it to play with the size and add a dimension. To remove a dimension, simply click on the lock. And that's it. Super easy. If I now zoom out a little bit, exit the sketch, I can select the sketch region, select the center line, create a revolve, and there is our first water bottle. Let's turn the sketch and design into a more interesting shape. This bottle I will delete. I will go to the front view, select a line, select sketch. It will go right into the sketch mode, and the arc I will simply delete. Then this point I can move down. And now I would like to fill this space with a spline. To draw a spline, it's very easy. Select spline. We have two different types, control and fit point. And then with the pencil, I simply start drawing and press and press. And every time I press, it adds another point. I go to the endpoint and release the pencil from the screen. These points I can move around. As you can see, this works very easy. A spline and line I can select and create a tangency constraint. You see then, you get beautiful transitions. Also here, I can bring this point down, move this down, there we are. What is very unique about the way how splines work in Shaper is how we can break splines, join splines, continue splines. For example, I select this point. You see there is a sharp point icon. When I select it, this spline is actually now split into two splines. I can join this into one spline by making this point smooth again. Super easy. Also, very good to know, when you start drawing a spline and you finished drawing it, you can continue adding to it. I can also draw somewhere else a spline and then join these by selecting that point, as I showed already, and setting this to smooth. Very easy. Let's take a look at how this bottle looks. There we are. Beautiful. Sketches can be very easily in 3D space moved, rotated, and scaled. Let's go to Sketch, Circle, and I create a basic circle and exit the sketch. Then I will select the circle, turn on Copy, and create myself a copy and move it along the Z-axis up. I can then select Scale. I have the non-uniform version turned on and scale this along the X and Y axis. I will select the circle one more time, move another copy up, and then turn copy off. Now I can rotate it. You see, this is how easy this works. At this point, it will be very good to show you that every time when you make a copy, it will create a new sketch inside the list. But check out what happens when I make a copy of this circle and move this one down. And then I select this ellipse, make a copy, move this one down. And when they are on the same plane, they will be put into the same container. When I select one element and move this away, it will put this into its own container. And all this actually happens automatically. This is very smart. To move this, I can select the sketch regions and then create a loft. Beautiful. Also, working with sketch intersections is very easy and natural. For that, let's create a small circle on the ground. Then this circle I will copy and move up. And the bottom circle I will scale along the x-axis. I will then go into the front view. Have nothing selected, add a sketch, and also because all our snap elements are turned on, you can now see that where this sketch cuts actually the top and the bottom sketch, we have snapping points. Which means now we can very easily create on the left and the right side two rails. I will draw a central line, lock this line, and then these two points, I will add a symmetry to this line. And now go to the 3D view and I exited the sketch. We'll call under tools the loft command. Select the first and the second sketch region, and now pay attention what happens. I will select the two rails, click done, and there's a 3D loft. This is so easy to do. You can also find the intersection between a 3D body and the sketch. We'll go to the front view. Create a sketch. And the moment we go into editing the sketch, you see the snapping points where this plane would intersect with geometry edges. This is actually very helpful because now from this snapping point, I can simply draw my lines to design the container under the slit. Very easy. Exit the sketch, select one region, midline, revolve. There we are. And as you can see, the resulting geometry perfectly matches up with the cap. The way how sketch guidelines work in Shaper is very smartly solved and works really great. Let's take a look at it. Let's make a sketch. And here I just draw a line. Now, when I select this point, we can see already the horizontal and vertical guidelines. I would like to extend this line. And all I need to do is select this point and move this along its normal direction. And this way I can grow or shrink it. That's it. Super easy. Let's draw another line. I would like this line to extend so that it actually meets where these two guidelines cut each other. To do this, I select this point. I can now freely move this around. Go to this end point and move this into the position now where these two projected guidelines intersect. Another very interesting situation also when we work with a line and an arc. Here's an arc. Pay attention to the open area, which is filled with the circular guideline. Down here now, I will draw a line. This endpoint, I will select, move this to the arc, and now you can see I can snap it onto that circular guideline. And automatically also a coincident constraint will be added. That means if I select this point and move it, the circle moves. When I move the circle, this line extends. And also here between this endpoint and this line along the guideline is a coincident constraint. So this is actually a really great ability to also work with constraints on guidelines. You can also project edges of a body into a sketch or sketch elements onto a body. I have here remote control and I will select the top surface face and then create myself an offset construction plane. This construction plane, for visibility purpose, I will scale down a little bit. There we are. Then I will select that body surface one more time, select my construction plane, and call the project command. That will create then a new sketch that perfectly matches the geometry below. I can then select the ring, go into sketch, zoom in. I will lock the ring so it cannot move, and add myself a second ring. Then exit the sketch. I will select both rings, zoom in, select the surface, and this time I will call the project command, but instead of projecting into a sketch, it will slice, project itself onto that surface. Click done. Very good. With that done, I can then go into the visualization mode, select the new surface, and change the material to finish that interface design.